Hi friends, welcome to Day 69 Daily Current Affairs. Today first news is Uttarakhand CM Rawat resigns. He is saying, I feel really honored that my party gave me the opportunity to serve. They have been nearly 4 years. This is a failed attempt of the BJP to cover up the failures of its government in the state and hide the corruption taking place there. On Tuesday, tendered his resignation to Governor Premier Rani Maurya, former Chhattisgarh Chief Minister Raman Singh, and Rajya Sabha Member Dushyant Gautam Singh by the BJP's national leadership. Attending the meeting of the legislative party, they voted to elect a new leader who will become the Chief Minister. 2% rising UPA SSC registered in 2019. 26 cases that year. There has been over 72% increase in the number of persons arrested under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act in 2019 compared to the year 2015 data provided by the Ministry of Commerce in the Lok Sabha show. Good questions. Delay in setting up environment regulator. Prashant Bhushan highlights government lapse despite 2011 order. The Supreme Court on Tuesday asked the government why it had not set up an independent environmental in Afghanistan, including a potential government involving the Taliban in a high-risk strategy, as he weighs whether to honor a deadline to end American longest war. Mumbai room search for anti-war protesters. Security forces intensify crackdown on Myanmar activists. People barricaded in a Yangon neighborhood overnight said on Tuesday that Myanmar security forces searched their homes. Mumbai room for anti-war protesters targeting. China has launched a healthcare certificate for Chinese international drivers, leading the world in plans for so-called virus passport. The digital certificate, which shows a user vaccination status and virus test results, is available for Chinese citizens via program on Chinese social media platform WeChat. Today's last news is imports after OPEC Plus. UPSC is looking at buying crude from Guyana. Deal with Russia sources. India has asked the State Department to suspend the diversification of oil imports to Brazil and cut their dependence on West Asian suppliers after OPEC Plus decided last week to launch the production cuts in April. Two sources said the first government of Israel and Iran imports about 84% of its commodities, with over 60% of the coming from West Asian countries, which are typically fueled by the West. India hit hard by rising oil prices. Responses of the energy minister.